Now, Jim Jones, Chrissy, I've been seeing some press about y'all coming back to Love & Hip Hop New York. So is this why y'all lost y'all house? If that was the case, y'all should have been talked about. Over, y'all lost $750,000 house. House went in foreclosure. And somebody bought off an auction for a goddamn $100. Bitch. Listen, y'all should have never left Love & Hip Hop New York. Y'all should never listen, Chrissy. You loved that nigga Jim Jones. You had, that was your motherfucking trophy, bitch. You hear me? And I was like, Chrissy, I'm like, you too pretty. You intelligent like a motherfucker. You too pretty. I'm like, you wasted all your fucking good years off this nigga. And this nigga still ain't motherfucking made an honest woman out your ass. I mean, you proposed to this nigga. And that nigga still ain't made an honest woman out of your ass. That's sad. That's sad. I don't know why y'all, listen, if y'all would have stayed on Love & Hip Hop New York, had that fucking money, and y'all could use that money to pay on that goddamn fucking house. Now, come on now, bro. John. Nigga, if the gigs are drying up, if you see your motherfucking music ain't selling like it, why y'all ain't save money? Invest in money. Do. And when Chris supposed to do like all fashion and shit? Bruh. That's sad. I know y'all felt sick to the stomach. Lost your goddamn house and somebody bought it for $100. Y'all need to be, if it's for real, that y'all going back to Love & Hip Hop New York, kind of defeat the purpose now, but hell, but y'all need money, apparently. You should never left. You should have never fucking left. It ain't matter if Yandy was, you know, the it girl of the show, or, you know, I think her and Mona, Yandy and Mona, Ace Bone Coon, fucked it. Bitch, you knew your motherfucking incomes were funny. Should have stayed on that motherfucker. You should have never left. I ain't know why y'all were leaving for it anyway. Cause to be honest, I was watching for your ass to see who you were gonna jump next. I ain't gonna be much love. Bruh. That's sad. Chris, you been with that nigga for how long? Cause when Love & Hip Hop New York first came out, if I remember right, you said, I think it was said that you was with Jim Jones for 8 years then. You did everything you knew how to get that nigga to marry you. You even proposed to get that nigga to marry you. Wasted all your fucking, your youth. You know when motherfuckers say all your good years, listen, as long as you live in, no matter how old and young you are, it's still technically your good years. But all in all, when your youth is gone, that's it. Girl. You know, you're gonna love who you wanna love. And you love who you wanna love. And I guess you said, well, I done put all the years up in his ass. I guess, girl. I fucking guess. Y'all should have never left. Love hip hop. Y'all could have caught them chicks. Still made them. You see, ain't Rich still on that motherfucker? And that nigga ain't managing nobody. He's still getting a check. You should never live. That's messed up. So what y'all gonna do? Y'all gonna move in with Jim Jones' mama? Nah, that's gonna be something to see. Boy, Jim Jones' mama ain't gonna never let this shit down. And the thing about with her, regardless of whatever, whoever was supposed to pay that mortgage and everything, Jim Jones' mama gonna put it all on Chrissy. She gonna put it all on Chrissy, y'all. Jim Jones, Chrissy, when y'all saw that y'all money was looking way more funny, y'all just been doot. Mona, hey, what's good? Yeah. I'm ready to come back on there. I'm ready to come back on the show. Do I have to apologize to Yandy or something? Sometimes you gotta swallow that pride, bitch. Boy. Sometimes you gotta swallow that goddamn pride. Lord Jesus. That's messed up. That's all the way messed up. Cha-cha.